Hi dear students, welcome back. So we have here the steps of the scientific research. We have here the first step is to form the question, then to introduce here the hypothesis, then after that to have the experiment, and then to write down your results, and then come up with the conclusions. In this step, we either we have to reject and revise the hypothesis, or you can here add additional hypothesis. After this, you're gonna come up with your theory. After that, other psychologists at this point, they do what? They do extra two steps. They can replicate and test their theories and ask another questions. So for research to be valid, proper scientific procedures must be used. Above are the steps that researchers generally follow. The following question is very important. What happens if the conclusions of an experiment do not support a hypothesis? So at the part of the conclusions, if it doesn't support here the hypothesis, so I'm gonna reject and revise hypothesis, or I'm gonna add another additional hypothesis. Okay, after this, find the main idea. Where does a hypothesis occur in the steps of research? What do you think? I have here hypothesis. Yes, hypothesis is after what? Is after question. It's the second step after a research question is formed. Okay, further steps in the scientific research, I have here the replication. For the findings of a study to be confirmed, the study must be replicated, which means it must be repeated, and produce the same results as before. So if you want to make sure this is right research, so I can repeat here the research, and if it produces the same results, so it will be accurate. Some scientists repeat a study under what? Under different circumstances and than in the original study. Sometimes the study is repeated with a different set of participants, so I'm gonna change the participants. I can change the circumstances of the original rather than the original study. If the study involves people, participants can vary in gender, so they can vary in gender, age, social and economic background, and location. I can add new questions. Research findings usually lead to new questions. New questions are tested using the same process. Different research methods are used to test the hypothesis. So these methods include the survey method, various here observational methods, and experimental method. And we're going to talk about this in more details. So we have to summarize here what we took. Why must the study be replicated in this part? Give three reasons. This is very important. It can come in the exam to see if it produces the same results under different what? Circumstances, the different set of participants, or different types of participants. Okay, so we're going to talk about section two the next session. Okay, so I hope you understood the lesson. Thank you for listening. Bye bye, dear students.